One of the things we love about wood is that it's a very simple material. There's a sense of warmth, comfort, security, all of these things, and we see that reaction.
People connect with it on a very cerebral level. Half the time they don't even know why they're connecting with it, it's just such a natural occurrence.
It's a psychological effect that wood has, and it's one of the reasons we continue to use it in our projects. The Millennium line was in fact a unique application where the client was quite forward thinking. They decided they'd like to try wood on these stations. It had never been done before in North America.
Peter Busby is an avid canoeist, and in his office he actually has an upside down canoe sitting in his atrium. And so when we were in the design office talking about what the station could be, he pointed up to that canoe and said, "That's the shape I'm looking for."
We were able to create a very three-dimensional cocoon-like shape. And again, that cocoon goes back to the idea of warmth, security, protection from the elements, and wood allowed us to do that extremely simply. The client was suggesting going to steel, steel ribs, steel decking. We actually priced it out, and the wood was cheaper. And in the end, the experience of Brentwood Station, of standing on the platform, is quite exceptional. You know, 10 years later, you look at Brentwood, and the wood has actually aged better and has shown higher durability than the steel pieces. We created a very elegant, sophisticated form, but out of very simple materials. It's just elevated the quality. At night, there's this incredible warm glow that comes from the building, which comes from the wood itself.
People gravitate towards the station, and the interesting thing is it's become such a signature station, not only for the line, but for what transit stations could be. It's success building upon success.
We took the ideas of Brentwood and we evolved them. We saw Lansdowne as an evolution in terms of prefabrication. We also had a lower construction cost. It was a much tighter budget, so we had to be very economical in what we did. We assembled Lansdowne, I think it was in about a week and a half, the whole roof was put up because they bolted together and then the roof membrane went on top.
Transit stations can be fairly utilitarian in cold places, and we wanted to pick it up a notch. We wanted to use wood in terms of adding a richness to this space and a warmth to the space that you would not necessarily have otherwise.
Coming across Kingsway, you're effectively in the heart of Burnaby, and the city of Burnaby wanted a bridge, obviously, to get pedestrians across Kingsway, but also they wanted something that had a showcase element to it, something that wasn't just your standard bridge. And so they wanted something light, something delicate, something innovative. On the Kingsway Bridge, wood is used primarily in compression, so the connections, if you walk by the bridge, you'll see there's very few connections that are visible. It's really just working as a compression element against these steel haunches, which is basically collecting all that that compression force and channeling it around so people can pass through the bridge.
We have technology that is again elevating the performance of wood to new levels. Glue lam, structure lam, timber strand, cross laminated timber. At the same time, you can take it a step further. You can start to look at composite panels and materials. You can incorporate steel strands. You can pre-stress them. They're called engineered woods for a reason. They've essentially engineered in reliability. I think our starting point for what we're doing and why we're doing it is climate change, addressing, mitigating the impacts of our built environment. Wood is clearly the most sustainable building material that we have. It's the only building material that's made by the sun.
For every cubic meter of wood fiber, you're sequestering a ton of carbon. If you're looking for a net zero building or trying to reduce the carbon footprint of your building, obviously the more wood you put into your building, the more you're going to offset your carbon footprint.
Wood really fits within that equation of sustainability.
What started as a BC innovation is really being taken across Canada now.
We'll certainly be seeing more sophisticated use of wood, more instances where wood has been elevated to an even more refined material.
We're finding more and more that it's becoming not only accepted but required and demanded in public facilities. The question of, well, we can't do that, it's now turned into, well, why can't we do that? Because now there's so many projects out there that are showing the success of wood.